and who is always, you know, at one call of Vijay sir, they are always there to gain the knowledge.
Yes, so yes, yes, yes.
Thank you very much. And also my gratitude, my, you know, great salute to all my gurus with whom I started my journey, Anna Guruji, Sri Krishna Vevareji, Kantali Mitra Mandal, and great, our beloved Dr. Professor Agashe sir, with whom, you know, I continued my journey at Somaiya Bombay University and still going on a long, long path, because learning never ends and spirituality is far, far away, which we are craving for. I hope you all are comfortable with English. For a few, you know, Hindi lovers, I may, you know, speak some Hindi words also. So let me introduce the topic. Now, Vijay sir, can you make me host or co-host just to
you can share, sir. No
okay.
problem.
Okay. Okay. So looking at the topic, you know, many of you must be surprised. Some odd name of the topic. We have heard of physiology of human body, anatomy of human body. So with that only my questions start. I'm in habit of interacting with the audience and asking questions which you all know very well. It won't be difficult. What do you mean anatomy? You know, structure of human body. What is physiology of human body? Yes, anyone can answer. Those who are sitting at the silent place can keep the speak mic unmuted.
So it's a function of your parts of the body.
Okay, that is physiology of human body. Yeah, you know, study of detailed study, you can say scientific study of functioning, how it functions. Same way here we are going to talk today. We have heard of yoga therapy. Nowadays yoga therapy is on the top priority or most popularity in the field of yoga, as you all know. Okay, people are more and more attracted due to this therapeutical aspect of yoga, though yoga is not meant for therapy. Therapy is just a side effect, or you can say byproduct of journey of yoga. But then people are more interested. So everybody is after yoga therapy and trying to become therapist. Even Ayush and Government of India also has introduced levels, various levels of examinations to become assistant and yoga therapist and consultant and all. So definitely we all are interested in knowing about yoga therapy, but how it functions exactly? Why, you know, yoga therapy has become so popular? Why the effect of yoga therapy as compared to other therapies is becoming more and more popular, favorite, comfortable, and of course costly also, which was not there. Yoga is never meant for therapy. It was the entire field or entire philosophy also was Param Gopniya Shastra, which was not to be, you know, openly shared with everybody. And then also therapy element was there since beginning. As you all know, Hatha Yoga has prescribed so many therapeutical aspects. We will discuss about that too. So this topic is mainly oriented on knowing all the, you know, modes of functioning and why and how it works, that we will try to understand. That's what is the basic intention of keeping this function, this session. Okay. Now, what is yoga therapy? We'll try to know, because physiology you all know very well. Yoga therapy also is known, but let us try to visit a couple of definitions. There are so many definitions, so many have described and prescribed. Previously, we were not believing in therapeutical aspect as being the original Indian, as it's our own culture, our own scripture. It is just an experiential science, not to be, you know, put for therapy purpose. But then Westerners, particularly Americans, Europeans, caught it. And then they started Yoga Therapy Association. So first definition I have taken from International Association of Yoga Therapists, which says that the process of empowering individual, making the individual enable or able to progress towards improved health and well-being. Of course, good health and well-being are separate aspects. So improved health and well-being through the application of philosophy and practice of yoga. So now those who are daily practicing yoga or joined some class, most of the classes you must have observed that it is only practices, practices, and practices. But now those who have done various academic courses, like Vijay sir has done and many of you have done, you know that unless it is based, you know, entire practice is based on philosophy or the scriptural description, the therapy practice will not be that much effective and the results oriented. And that's why philosophy also is equally important. To know ins and out and basic understanding of philosophy will make you a better practitioner. And a better practitioner can never, you know, effort to invite diseases. So it's good health being also. And therapy basically automatically is going on with the entire journey of the yoga. That is what you know, International Association of Yoga Therapists has defined. But now, as the government of India has started so many things, so this association, government of India is not recognizing, but definitely they have got a very, very big membership and association all over the world. And they have prescribed actually the minimum hours for a therapist. In India, you know, within 2 hours of 3 days camp or shibir or classes, people are trying to become therapists. Even if they are not therapists, simple yoga certificate holder or, you know, teacher, they start therapy, giving therapy to the patients, because most of the time what we invite is diseased patient or patients coming with problems. Even our regular new class also, if you go through the admission forms, most of them having some or other problems. Some of them have been, you know, sent by orthopedic surgeons or gynecologists that you go and do yoga. Then my, you know, therapy or medical therapy will be more effective, will be more accelerative if you do yoga. And that's how they also prefer. In our Ghatkopar also, I have seen so many orthopedic surgeons, they send so many patients to our yoga center and Gandhali center and other centers to learn yoga. And without, of course, we never allow them to stop medicines, but those medication will be more effective and the recovery will be faster with yoga therapy. And that's how, you know, this therapy is becoming more and more popular. R. Bronstein has defined yoga therapy as it is, and really I like this therapy, the definition. That's why I have taken as compared to so many other definitions. It is an ideal application. Yoga therapy is preventive in nature as yoga itself. Basically, we all know that yoga is basically preventive. Okay. But it is also restorative in many instances, palliative in others, and curative in many others. So all these aspects are covered under the head of yoga therapy. And we will discuss each and every aspect, how it is. And that's how, you know, no other therapy is giving so many aspects together. That's how it is so popular. And we'll consider all these aspects, okay? The basic approach of yoga therapy also we will try to discuss. First of all, preventive aspect, which is obviously basic aim of yoga, as I have told you. And Patanjali also has told the same thing. Heyam dukham anagatam. Means, jo dukh abhi tak aaye nahi, aane wale, whichever miseries and pains you are going to face in future, that can be prevented. That can be got rid of. Okay, that's what Patanjali says. Or of course, Patanjali has not stopped there. He has given the remedies also, which we will discuss if time permits. So this is what basic aim of yoga, but yoga therapy definitely covers that. And that's how, you know, you under the heading of yoga therapy, and while discussing the functioning of it, we will discuss each and every aspect, how it is useful. So it is useful not only to the patients, to the healthy persons also who wants to promote the health. So promotive aspect also is covered, because nowadays in corona time, immunity enhancement is most important. You all are hearing of that. That immunity should be there. Then even if corona is infected your nose or throat, you can prevent it going into the lungs. Definitely, thousands of people have done that, prevented. You have heard of Jalaneti practice, where, you know, at Pune Hospital, 600 staff members, right from doctor to ward boy and nurses, they were practicing Jalaneti for 1 month, and none of them, in spite of, you know, treating the corona patient, in spite of remaining in corona ward, none of them infected. Only 15 patients became corona positive who was not regularly practicing jalaniti. Okay, so this is the result which says that definitely you can increase immunity not only for corona but for any disease, particularly allergic diseases, respiratory diseases, TB, and so many things can be prevented. So it is promotive aspect, restorative aspect. Whenever you are recovering from any surgery, any fracture, any accident, any severe, you know, disease, irreversible diseases, so called, you know, it is considered in the medical field, all these things, when you are after surgery or after trauma, when you are recovering, this aspect, restorative aspect, will help you. You will say that in surgery yoga is not that helpful. Of course, agree. Whenever it is needed, allopathy is always acting on, you know, acute problems. But then when you are recovering or during the treatment also, the accelerated or fast recovery will take place. Positive mindset, so that the medicine will be effective. And that is what has been tried by doctors and medical science also for so many years together. You know, the placebo effect, that says, that itself says, that without medicine also, if mindset is positive, that definitely this capsule is going to cure me, then the patient is cured. Okay. So this is the restorative aspect. Then one aspect is adjuvant, supportive aspect, along with other therapy. The first is allopathy, of course, but along with other therapy, this becomes additional supportive therapy. Then palliative aspect. Palliative is nothing but minimizing your symptoms through which you are suffering a lot. You know, काफी कुछ suffering, दुख हो रहा है, problem आ रहा है, so many things are there, back pain, neck pain, insomnia, all these, most of them are lifestyle disorder or psychosomatic disorder, where, you know, modern medicine also is doing the same thing. What is that? Symptomatic relief. Okay, as you take crocin, temperature comes down, but again after 8 hours temperature might shoot up if infection is there or if something is abnormal inside your body and mind. Definitely, you know, one will suffer, again you take medicine. So every time it is symptomatic relief, including antibiotic also. 5 days or 10 days course, if you do, you will be out of infection, but then there is no guarantee because basic root cause is not removed. So after few days or few months, again it can come when the atmosphere changes, when the throat infection is there, when allergy is there. So many reasons are there. Sources are unlimited in our world, you know that. And day by day, depending, I mean, as compared to number of medicines, number of sources from where you get the disease is increasing. So palliative aspect also is most important. And many of you, you know, when you join yoga first time, you must have experienced that little problems, little pain, like acidity also. Such problems are immediately attended by yoga therapy. So this is palliative aspect. And I have kept lastly the curative aspect, which many people are claiming in the field of yoga also, that come and get cured. Even asadhya rog, which are non-curable, also can be cured. But then such claims should not be made by yoga therapists, but definitely yoga has got this aspect, curative aspect. And few diseases, you know, which are not chronic, like PMS, premenstrual syndrome, okay, COPD, PCOS, all these which are in early stage, even cancer also, which are in early stage, can 100% be cured. And many of yoga scholars, yoga teachers who are here, present here, they must have experienced in our circle also, those who are suffering from asthma, for example, they are totally dependent on the, you know, pump, those aerosols pumps for asthma, and medicines, deriphyllin injections or tablets and all, diabetic patients who are totally dependent on insulin therapy. After coming to yoga, after so many sincere days of practices, they have totally come out of the diseases. And they are not dependent on those pumps and medicines now. And medical science also admits that if you don't require the medicine for more than 10 years, then you are totally out of disease. Means disease is cured. And there are so many patients in my circle. Now, they are not patients, of course. They have been totally cured. Their medicines are stopped 10 or 15 years back. And they are living normal life. So there is curative aspect in yoga therapy. Okay, But why this is happening? We are interested in physiology. Why it happens? Why such a beautiful results we get out of yoga therapy as compared to all other therapy? There are three main aspects I would like to discuss here, which most of you know, but let us have, you know, a quick journey through them. One is holistic approach, one is integrated and holistic. What is holistic? You know, our lifestyle includes mainly diet, exercise, movements, okay, relaxation, that is leisure and rest, and of course, positive approach, proper attitude. These all are part of, you know, a proper lifestyle or healthy lifestyle. So each and every issue is addressed by holistic approach of yoga. If you undergo 1 hour or more than that, you know, session of yoga, it will be a combination of all these aspects. And finally, slowly, gradually, you will be, you know, getting positive results at each and every level of these aspects. And finally, if you are overtaking all these aspects, definitely you will be, you know, walking on the spiritual path, which will take you further up. And that path will bring, of course, holistic results also. Next is integrated approach. You all know very well that our health is total integration of pancha koshas as per yoga or as per Taittiriya Upanishad. So all these koshas, if you keep them integrated, then health is there. If it is disintegrated, then disease is there. So simple to understand. Okay. So yoga brings about correction at each and every aspect of these koshas or each and every layer or, you know, aspect of our personality, which is made up of physical, vital, intellectual, mental, emotional, all kind of aspect. And finally, if you can coordinate all these aspects, then the result is Anandamay Kosh or spiritual aspect. So it is this kind of journey which, you know, makes corrections at all this level. Okay, 5 seats of our personality, you all know. So that's how, you know, yoga gives you that result also. Personality development or total personality. This is what we get. And then third aspect is holistic aspect. It looks at you as a whole unit, not each and every part of the body, which other doctors or, you know, medical experts or other so-called therapists are looking at, either your eyes or the nose or ENT or only digestive system or gynec system. Because gynec will never bother about what your eyes are, what your digestive system is. They are only concerned with reproductive system. And they can attend only that much. Restricted knowledge is only that much. Whereas yoga therapist or yoga therapy or yoga practices, they, with the 1 or 2 techniques also, they start corrections at each and every level. Though you are doing Pavan Muktasana only for relieving of gases, but along with that, your digestion will be properly set. Your spinal muscles will be, you know, becoming more and more flexible and stronger. Along with that, you know, maintenance of that asana for a long time will increase the mental capability and self-confidence and respiratory benefit. Along with that, so many things will start. Excretory system also will get the benefit. So it starts looking at you as a whole unit, and whole unit is complete health. So yoga gives you complete health. That's why these three main approaches, which is responsible for popularity of yoga therapy. One should understand that. Okay, our real heart of today's topic, how and why yoga therapy functions. What is the real, you know, suspense or, you know, secret of yoga therapy's popularity or success? So let us try to discuss that. And here also, your suggestions, your inputs are welcome. In between, you can stop me anytime to ask questions or to clear your confusion. If anything is wrong, you can correct me also. Because whatever is my experience, my knowledge, accordingly I go. So your knowledge may differ. And I believe in Anekantvad. Everybody is right at some particular time. So this is the time for you also, not only for me. So first point is gradually, but most effectively, yoga therapy works. Why gradually and slowly? Because the disease has started from the root cause, which is not reflected on the body level. Whenever you get as hyperacidity or abdominal pain or back pain or neck pain, knee pain or insomnia, the root cause is not at the body level. not at the back also. Stress is accumulated there. Stress might be the root cause, which is the mental stress. Okay. So Yoga Vasishtha also says that Manomai Kosha is the root cause. If you don't attend that, the problem or the suffering gets percolated to Pranamai Kosha and results into haphazard prana or breathing or irregular breathing, insufficient breathing, shallow breathing, all that we don't bother. Why? Because our life is smooth. We are working as usual. Nothing is bothering us. We never notice our breath. Before coming to yoga, who had noticed the breath? Because it is under the control of involuntary system. So we are least bothered. Why we, what we have to control, for that also we are least bothered. So which is not in our control, we are least bothered. So yoga therapy or yoga practices has to reach up to the root cause, which is Manomai Kosha. And we don't attend Pranamai Kosha, the problems are reflected at Annamai Kosha. And that time we come to know, oh, I have got backache or neckache or eye burnings or insomnia. All these are manifestation at the Annamai Kosha. Okay, but from Annamai Kosha, yoga has to reach up to the root cause, Manomai Kosha, which takes time. Because onset of diseases also has taken time. You never bothered with small, small problems. Ek goli khao, kaam pe chalo. Aisa hi humne kiya hai. Because kaam to humare bina ruk jayega, building gir jayega agar nahi pahunchenge to. That is our psychology. That's how we never afforded to close our shop, business, job or whatever it is. So yoga has to reach, you know, penetrating through all these layers, reach up to Manomai Kosha. And luckily, fortunately, yoga is the only field out of all the health field which is dealing with the mind. Okay. And that's why I have added the last sentence. It is the strength of mind and not the dose of medicine which helps illness. Even with the medicine, if strength is not there of the mind, if your mind is so weak, अरे दो लोग को कोरोना हो गया और एक्सपायर हो गए, मुझे भी होगा तो मैं भी हॉस्पिटल में जाऊंगा तो definitely if mind says that, you will go there. Sorry. So mind is responsible for this. Then second is, along with effectiveness, it is economical also. As you all know, yoga therapy or any yoga practice is not incurring any cost. Are you agreeing with this? So many of you must have, you know, incurred some cost in learning yoga. Yes, madam, I can't hear you.
Okay, anyone want to ask anything?
I think he was unmuted by default.
By default.
Anyway. Even if you want to do yoga at home, nowadays everything is at home, isn't it? So you require a mat. Even if you don't want to incur cost on mat, the simple towel or your bed sheet is enough, isn't it? So it is costless. All as compared to all other therapy where the day by day the cost is increasing, here the cost is decreasing. So many free classes are opening up because everybody at every house, every mohalla, there is a yoga teacher who wants to teach so many things. So it is costless. Okay. Now what to take, what to adapt and what not, it is up to you. And yoga therapy works innocently. Why innocently? No dosha. It removes the dosha actually, tridosha. But why yoga therapy has no dosha? Because no side effect. If you do it properly, if you learn first properly, your expert, your teacher, your guru says that you are doing correctly, then you can do on your own. Of course, that is the first criteria, that you should learn from a matured and expert teacher, not from the TV and textbooks and all. Okay, nowadays many people are doing that and they are coming to yoga center with problems and side effect. But basically, proper practice has no side effect. Okay. And side effects of medicine also it can remove slowly and gradually. Okay, there is no invasion. So no surgery, no cutting of the body, no looking inside like endoscopy and all. automatically, if the teacher is expert, he will come to know from your body language, from the level of pain, from your movement, from your walking and practicing, doing asanas, he will come to know where exactly is the problem. So no need of going into further investigation. Then yoga therapy works independently. Okay, nobody else is involved. Once you learn the technique, you can do on your own. Nobody else is required. Okay, and of course, it is self-indicative. When you are doing on your own, you will come to know whether I am doing correctly or something is wrong. Again, one example here, like in Kapalbhati, it is told that at the end of Kapalbhati, when you stop giving strokes, okay, what should you feel? You should feel completely relaxed, the peaceful state of mind, the, you know, automatic cessation of breath. If it doesn't happen, then at least breathing should slow down. It should become rhythmic. It should come under your control. If none of this happens, then something is wrong. So it is self-indicative. Then you should go to the expert and get it corrected. This is what the indication is. Like that, so many practices will offer so many benefits. And if you don't get the benefits, and instead of that, if you get some pain, or if you pant for the breath, or uneasiness, or uncomfort, that means you have not done it properly. Again, you should correct the way you are doing it from the expert. Okay. So this self-indicative means those who are practicing, you know, sincerely and with full of awareness, they will feel all the changes, all the corrections, and accordingly will move on the path. Even Patanjali has mentioned, no, in Vibhuti Path, which are the indicators that what is your progress, you will come to know on your own. Don't exhibit to others, but then you are the right person who can judge that I'm walking on the right path. That's why these, miraculous things are happening with me. Then, of course, that happens on the spiritual path, but on the therapy path also, you will start getting the results slowly and gradually. And you will start obtaining positivity in your life, in your mind. These are the indicators. Okay. And here, patients or practitioner can control the results. It is in the hand of practitioner. This is the main characteristic, or I have mentioned it in limitations also, that patient himself is responsible on, you know, the progress, on the step on which he is getting cured. Okay, so he can control the results. If he wants to, you know, get it cured very fast, he should go accordingly. Actually, what happens, you know, in practical life, thoda bahut achha lagta hai na when you get some positive result. Theek hai, yoga side mein, because other priorities are there, yoga becomes less and less on priority because he is getting well. That wellness is there. Many times it happens, you know, in our yoga center where we are attached to there for about 30 years, Gandali Mitra Mandal and other centers also. The person who was regular practitioner for so many years suddenly disappears and comes after 3-4 years. Hey, we ask, where were you? What happened to you? He says that, no, I was all right. That's why I was not coming. Now, again, due to some problem, I have to come. So person doesn't understand that if you continue practice, then you will not have to come again and again. Everything goes smoothly on its own. So yoga is a lifetime process, of course. Like all other routine things which we are doing, going to toilet, taking bath and all. Like that, yoga should become part of our life. And that's why it is said that yoga is a way of life. For the advanced practitioner, you don't have to spend 1 hour also. It becomes 24/7 awareness. And that is what yoga is. Okay. One more, the secret of functioning is it works in line with the nature. Okay. The approach of yoga therapy should be going towards the nature, not away from the nature. And also it is, the therapy is based on scriptures. That is the right therapy. Nowadays, you know, like symptomatic relief, instant relief or instant practices are being framed or formulated or designed or manipulated just to become a therapist. But that is not the real therapy practice, because that will not give long-lasting, you know, relief. So, which is based on scriptures, or at least some principles of the scripture that will take you towards the nature. And nature, you all know, external nature, internal nature are same. You know, universe also is made up of Panchamahabhut. Our body also is made up of panchamahabhut. So if you are playing with that panchamahabhut inside, you know, shortage of water, not drinking properly, going against the nature, not going to the sleep at right time, 3 to 4 hours after sunset, where your activity should be reduced, and slowly after completion of all the works, you should go to sleep. That nowadays, particularly the modern generation, they don't do that. They are going to sleep 2 o'clock, 4 o'clock, which is again going against the nature. And then problems will come. So this yoga therapy will tune your lifestyle or life routine towards the nature, which will, one of the reasons which will cure you, or you will be minimizing suffering and problems in your life. Okay. And this yoga therapy is extraordinary system or infrastructure gifted to us. Yoga therapy works on that gift. Our each and every part of the body, if you observe, the extraordinary working is there, right from the pumping of the heart, lungs, you know, even intestine. So many times we are mishandling, we are torturing, and then also they are cooperating. For more than 100 years, it is designed for. But because of our wrong handling and wrong lifestyle, our life ends very early, or the problem, onset of problem is very early. So, you know, and there is so many types of self-repairing systems inside, like stress management system is there inside. Your sutta-mata digestive problems also get cured inside. Menstruation also, if mindset is set corrected, that problem also will set properly. Hormonal balance also will take place. So all these things, self-repairing system is there. And yoga handles such a nice system. That's why therapy is more effective. Okay. Each yoga technique is multi-beneficial. As I told you, one technique if you do for one system, it will be definitely helping other systems also. Because yoga, Ayurveda, naturopathy, they believe that each and every system could be studied separately, but they are always working in coordination with each other. Each and every system is depending on others. So if yoga corrects the mindset by, you know, properly making the hypothalamus positive, or corrections of the emotions, or sublimation of the emotions, that one thing, if you do, even bhakti yoga can do this, sublimation of emotions. And with that, pituitary also will start functioning properly, because it is very next neighbor to hypothalamus. And both are interdependent and coordinated with each other. One is providing stimulating hormones to other. Okay, that's how, if pituitary start working properly, then pituitary is the head of department, head of all the other endocrine glands. So it will control other hormones also. And this is how, you know, any organ which is not giving proper function will start functioning properly. And that's how all the yoga therapists have, you know, formulate this HPO axis. So any one correction will correct others also. So this is how it is multi-beneficial. In same way, the other way also, if we do asanas, kriyas and all, making all the internal sphincters and system and intestine, okay, then slowly, you know, all the hormonal balance also will take place. Nervous system also will coordinate properly with endocrine glands. And this will affect hypothalamus and pituitary both. So HPO axis works again in line with each other from one end to other and other end to first end. And if all the ends are taken care of with regular yoga practices, then the further path is of spirituality or Anandamayi Kosh. Let us visit few of the scriptures. I will not go into all scriptures which is giving the right predict of yoga therapy. Bhagavad Gita, okay. Each and every shloka, each and every chapter, you know, takes you towards removal of course, depression starts from the first chapter, okay. And as you take support of Bhagavad Gita, definitely depression has to fly off. And this is just an example of depression. But so many things like frustration and so many other things, you know, conflict in our mind, which we daily face, either from the family or the working place, or even the road also. If somebody is bothering, somebody is not wearing mask and sneezing, we are immediately getting disturbed. So all these kind of things will taken care of by following the path which Sri Krishna has shown. Patanjali Yoga Sutra, you know, most of your, you know, students of Patanjali, He has given diagnosis also. Somebody was asking me that finally yoga therapy has to take support of medical science, no, for diagnosis. Yes, true, definitely. As in every when requirement is there, it has to go for blood test or X-ray or EEG, ECG. Everywhere diagnosis is required. But Patanjali has shown so many places where diagnosis is there. Okay. Which are self-indicators as we have discussed, okay? And along with diagnosis, remedies also is given. What will happen with some of the 9 antarayas or obstacles? He has shown diagnosis as sahabhuva. This will happen. You know, tremors will come to you. Dukkha, dharma, nasya will come to you. This shows that something is wrong internally. You have to correct it. And for corrections, he has given so many things, you know. And first and foremost, basic root cause of most of the diseases or most of the 9 antarayas also is kleshas, which he has, you know, given emphasis on kleshas. And mother of all the kleshas we know is avidya, due to ignorance or wrong knowledge, which we have already inculcated, and we have covered that right knowledge with so many worldly knowledge, wrong knowledge. So all this will be corrected as the path shown by Patanjali Yoga Sutra. Okay, what are they? This is the main cause, but all remedies are given, which is mainly based on union of body, mind and soul, which is the meaning of yoga itself, the word yoga, which is union, joining all three together. Though our journey currently is only to keep body and mind together, we have not reached up to soul also. But once we get control over keeping body and mind together, definitely we can reach up to our own self, and then self-realization can take place. But currently we are interested only in therapy. So let us travel on that. Therapy is chitta vritti nirodha also. He has shown nirodha and upaya also he has given. Okay, so many upayas. I have just quoted few only, which are most important for our therapy purpose. Shaucha, cleansing. External we are very much aware of, but internal cleansing he has talked of. Not only physical internal organs cleaning, but mental cleaning also. Mental purification. And of course, Patanjali's main intention is on mind, chitta. But Hatha yogis are mainly giving all the practices of shaucha at body level also. And Patanjali has given remedy for chitta vritti nirodha also. Consistent abhyasa. If you continue your abhyasa consistently, sattva dirgha kala, nairantarya, satkar seritu, then automatically you will start developing an attitude of discrimination, where you will come to know what is wrong for me and what is right for me. And what is wrong for me, I have to get detached. That gives you vairagya. So this both path, abhyasa and vairagya, are to be run, to be walked together. And that's how we can at least control to some extent our chitta vrittis. Virama pratyaya. And that will definitely give us a mode of relaxation, peaceful state of what we are doing. You know, we stop doing all the wrong things which are there in our life. Of course, Kriya Yoga also has different varieties of participants in the stage of our disease. We can practice whatever is suitable to us. Like Kriya Yoga, where Tapa, Svadhyaya and Ishwar Pranidhan, each and every aspect has got beautiful, you know, description and practices, which if we do seriously, consistently and with full of awareness, definitely we get the results in the form of therapy. Then Eka Tattva Abhyasa. See, Patanjali has given liberty to select that Eka Tattva in our own way. Though he has indicated pranava, pranava sadhana or japa sadhana also in Eka Tattva Abhyasa. But along with all the chitta prasadhanas, he has given yatha, abhimata. Whatever we like and where we can focus our awareness, we can develop the focusing power. We should select that positive object and we should continue that practice. That liberty no other therapy is giving you. Each and every therapy has got some rules and regulation. But this freedom, if we take it positively and correctly, definitely is for our own benefit and our own therapy or, you know, getting better and better. Chitta prasadhanas. I will not go into details. You all, most of you are very well knowing how to purify your mind and make it more and more blissful, joyful and prasanna chitta. That is the result. And if chitta is prasanna, how can, you know, any disease or any symptom can come? That is the main, you know, remedy which he has given the main emphasis on maitri, karuna, mudita, upeksha. By that, if you can develop that kind of attitude, even up to some extent, even in your life dealing with some person, definitely you will not go into stress, going into emotional disturbances, which will result into diseases. For prevention also and for treatment also, both way chitta prasadana will help you. Okay, pratipaksha bhavana, thinking of opposite. Most of the time, have you tried this anytime that you make a note or diary at the end of day before going to sleep? What kind of thoughts you went across during the day? What kind of actions you have taken across the day? If you do that, you will find that out of all the thoughts that those visited your mind, 80-90% of the thoughts are raga dvesha oriented or negative thoughts. Hardly you were having positive thoughts, except the yoga session, hardly any time you will have. So the need of the day is you have to convert those negative thoughts into positivity. Okay, positive thoughts. Of course, saying is easy, practicing is very difficult, but over a period of time, with consistent practice, we can do that. And there are indicators of treatment and goal, both Patanjali has prescribed very well. We will not go into details as we have discussed few. And other scriptures like Upanishad, Panchakoshas, you all know very well, and remedy also is given at all levels, integration should be done. Ayurveda is talking of asat mendriyartha sayoga. So if you are misusing our senses or even our intellect, we are not using properly with ignorance and avidya, then definitely it is pragna parada. Okay, crime against the intellect or wisdom, and that should be corrected. So this is the cause of diseases, what Patanjali has indicated, Ayurveda and Upanishads also has indicated. Yoga Vasishtha also has told that most of the diseases are adhija vyadhi, oriented on the mind, miseries and all. If you remove that disease, then you remain in happiness. But if you remove avidya, then definitely permanent happiness, which is moksha, which is liberation. Okay, so this all yoga therapy is mainly oriented on yogic lifestyle. What yogic lifestyle includes? Of course, diet is I have kept first, because you do all the rest of things, exercise, gymnasium, yoga, everything, meditation and everything. But if you don't take care of diet, ahara which you take, then everything is in vain. Nothing will be as effective as it is claimed. Okay, so diet, of course, one should take care of Hatha Yoga and every, you know, yogic scripture, naturopathy, Ayurveda, everybody has prescribed the proper sattvic, santulik, mitahar. Exercises, ahar, vihar, visranti, diet, exercise, and relaxation. These three are main aspects at physical level and mental level. Positive, correct attitude, correct approach. Okay, notional corrections, which happens at Vigyanmay Kosh. And all these three are at other three koshas. So if you have proper joyful, you know, with full of awareness, body movements are there, then definitely, you know, one of the main aspect is covered, which is yoga asanas or exercise. Of course, yogic exercise with breathing and full awareness and all. So these are the four main aspects of your lifestyle, which are properly taken care of. Then yoga therapy automatically, you know, you should take any disease as the gift from the God. Why? Because God has given us chance to correct our lifestyle. We were never knowing that our lifestyle is wrong. We were so much occupied in the external world that we never bothered about the proper, you know, quality of our life. So in the form of some symptoms or in the form of disease, the God has at least looked at you and given some disease, some indication that now at least you change your lifestyle. So take any disease, including cancer, as the opportunity to change the lifestyle. To look at these four aspects, this is how yoga therapy is consisting of. Okay, now to correct specific cleansing and body alignment techniques, Shuddhi Kriya and asanas, and Sukshma Vayam also is for body alignment. Control of breath leads to control of mind. Chale vate chalam chittam, nishchale nishchalam bhavet. So that's how directly taking control over mind is next to impossible. Very, very difficult. But this is the easier way our rishis and munis have given, that you do pranayam and you manipulate your breathing, extend your breathing so that you can slowly and gradually you know, take control from involuntary control of breathing to voluntary control. And its modification, that is, you know, mental modification or chitta vritti pe control or apna pura corrections liya ja sakta hai. That is the capacity. Then internal practices, dana, dhyan, samadhi, right from pratyahara, all these, you know, not only this Patanjali's yoga, but you go to any Indian philosophy, Buddhism, Jainism, Hinduism, everywhere, you know, internal practices are the main source to remove avidya, like dhyana in the form of samadhi. Some way are different way, like dhyana yoga, bhakti yoga, everything is described. So management of day-to-day stress also has been taken care of with proper, you know, suggestions given to your mind during meditation or resolves given in the yoga nidra. This all will help you to take care of. Discrimination power can be attained by jnana yoga, detached attitude, vairagya, because once we know, automatically it comes. Tuning of psychophysiological apparatus also will start taking place, and which will take you towards positivity. And finally, the result will be internal bliss and peace of the mind. Okay. Because with this particularly internal practices, the parasympathetic dominance will happen. Most of the stress and other related problems comes with activation of sympathetic nervous system, fight and flight situation. So to come out of that situation, all these practices, pranayam, meditation, yoga nidra, okay, all these will help you. Health benefits, I need not go into detail of all this list. You all know very well. You can go through this, right, from kriya, which removes the toxins, improved digestion, excretion, circulation. At the mental level, cognition power improves, vital capacity, and all kind of things, you know. You will be surprised that some of the cardiovascular exercises will definitely improve the strength of the heart. But some of the other practices, like multi beneficial aspect of yoga. If you do Dhyan Agnisar, how heart will be affected? If diaphragm goes up, you know, it touches the ventricles of the heart. And if ventricles are strengthened and stimulated and vibrations are given, then definitely the flow of the blood from the heart through the aorta will increase. The pressure will increase. The oxygen supply will increase. And all other organs will be benefited. This is how it has got direct and indirect effects. And BMI and weight management, everybody is practicing in the society and getting the benefit. Slow and gradual weight management is permanent. Okay. Joint problems, diabetes, balancing of hormones, improved coordination among all the systems, and all this will result into homeostasis, the exact, you know, perfect equilibrium of all the systems, temperature, pressure, okay, heart rate, everything will be set into proper place on the proper track. And when homeostasis is there, there won't be any disease. There won't be any symptoms. So each and every practice of yoga takes you towards homeostasis. Okay, how it works? Various modes of actions, we have seen few, and these are the few more. Okay, as I have told you, you know, Shuddhi Kriya for Vamana Kriya or Shankha Prakshala, it takes control over reflexes. Otherwise, reflexes are involuntary. All the sphincters are one way. They are not in our control. But when you do all these kind of things, one of the example is Apan Vayu, which normally is moving downward. But when you practice like Noli Kriya or Shankha Prakshala and all, it starts moving upward. And it removes all the impurities which is there in the upper part of the body also, in the form of, you know, all the exhalation or vomiting and all other things will happen, and the impurities will be removed. Asana, Sukshma Vyayam, Surya Namaskar, we have talked everything. Detoxification also is the result of asanas and all, by, you know, increasing the blood circulation and removing impurities. You know, lymph is there for immunity also and removal of impurities also. Now, for circulation of the blood, the pump is heart. But for circulation of lymph, nothing is there. How lymph can be circulated and remove the impurities, you know? Only the body movements, the exercises, the asanas, sukshma vayam will do that job. And that's why sedentary lifestyle will invite diseases, because there is no movement of the lymph. Lymph is totally static. Lymph should always move and, you know, supply something, exchange to the blood, and everything should happen. Okay, and asanas also has got capacity to take you towards infinity, samadhi, directly. Patanjali has told that, Prayatna Shaitilya, Ananta Samapatibha. The way it is described, if you do in that way, particularly meditative asanas, where Sthiram Sukham Asanam is there, if you do in that manner and minimizing your efforts, definitely the result is infinity, where again there are no disease. So our ultimate goal is no disease, but then when we start traveling on that path, the in-between stations or side effect is relieving of the pain, relieving of the symptoms, and that is what yogan therapy is there. Okay, pranayams we have discussed, taking control over autonomic nervous system. So all that thing which no other therapy can do, yoga has got this capacity of taking control over autonomic nervous system, the respiratory center also. Okay, and if you can take control over respiration, then control over mind becomes easy, that we have seen. Mudras, bandhas, of course, hormonal balance is there, channelizing of pranic energy. Hatha yoga has claimed that it can lead up to, you know, awakening of kundalini and chakra benefit also, which is high claim. But then, as I told you, high claim one can keep in mind, but start traveling at least, so you start getting all the benefits in your disease, in your symptoms and all. And relaxation, yoga nidra, shavasana and all, which will, you know, bring about management of stress, power of concentration, positive vibrations, like mantra, japa, om chanting and all, even brahmari, will give you proper setting of vibrations, which will correct or tune the functioning of each and every organ, which is malfunctioning or not giving results properly. Okay. And final result is realization of the goal in your resolve or in your positive suggestions during relaxed mind, because relaxed mind only can reach up to subconscious mind. So finally, you can reach up to self-realization. So lifestyle disorders, these are the list of mainly prevailing lifestyle disorders in current era, including insomnia in this given list. And the main causes also, we have discussed most of them, so I will not go into details of this. Okay, now, as you know, any other system, when we learn physiology, we are learning the disorders also. Same way in yoga therapy also, there are some limitations. Okay, where you can't call it as disorders, but where yoga therapy cannot work or cannot give you results, expected results. So one should keep in mind this and give accordingly the idea to the patient. Okay, don't claim that it can be cured. Okay, so if you are going against the nature, then it is not that effective. Okay, so it is natural way of healing, but it is not all cure. Everything cannot be cured. And main the aspect is tailor-made. Normally, yoga therapy should be given on one-to-one basis, because each and every mindset is different. Yatha mata tatha mana. Okay, so whatever he thinks, slowly, slowly he becomes like that. So every individual is different. So you have to design the practice or yoga module according to the mindset and physical constitution of that person. That should be the actual way of yoga therapy. But again, this is limitation, because you can't give a generalized or standardized yoga practice. There is no standardization. You can't give a prescription that 3 times you do Bhujangasana for 3 days and back pain and neck pain will go away. No. One person, it will go away within 2 days. And one person, the pain will increase. So there are varieties of, you know, bodies, body languages and mindsets. So according to the result you will get. Okay. So it can't be prescribed. And it is not possible to treat acute problems, painful accidents, surgery cases, poison, infections, accidents. You have to take support of allopathy and other pathies. Okay. Active cooperation of the patient is must. This is again the limitation. This is the only therapy where patient has to remain active. All other therapies, whether it is acupressure, acupuncture, pranic healing, reiki, or massaging, the therapist has to become active. Patient has to not do anything. He will be injected by doctor, he will be all right. But here, patient has to do all the time, all the things. And that's why I'm always telling all the yoga therapists that don't give assurance or guarantee. Whenever a person approaches you, don't tell that I cannot cure you. That also is wrong. Okay, come here. We will try together. Yoga has got capacity to cure. But ke baad, it is up to you to get cured. how seriously, how consistently, how regularly you do with full of awareness. That is the problem. And that's why cancer patients are getting cured faster than acidity patients. Why? Because acidity patients takes yoga as casual technique. Whereas cancer, there are, in front of cancer patients, there are only two options, either death or yoga. And that's how yoga is more effective. And active cooperation of patient is must, and patient has to have patience and determination, dedication. So yoga can take support. These are, see, costless, you know, props which one can take. If person with lumbar spondylosis or neck spondylosis, if he cannot do Ustrasana or Dhanurasana, he can take support of the chair and take benefits of backward bending, where the anterior muscles are stretched, posterior muscles are compressed, and that's how all the benefits can be taken. If total forward bending is not possible, take support of the blocks which are available at home or outside, or these strings or belts are available at home. घर पे और कुछ नहीं मिलता है तो वाइफ का दुपट्टा मिलेगा, ये सब चीज का यूज हो सकता है, अपना जेंट्स का बेल्ट भी यूज कर सकते हो. सो इट इज टोटली कॉस्टलेस. ऑल दिस प्रोब्स कैन बी यूज्ड एट इनिशियल बिकॉज पेशेंट्स कैन नॉट डू ऑल दिस थिंग्स. सो समटाइम्स सपोर्ट इज नीडेड. फॉर एग्जाम्पल भुजंगासन, इवन फॉर पेशेंट्स, वेरी इजी वर्जन इज गिवन लाइक दिस, फुल सपोर्ट ऑफ फोरआर्म्स, एंड देन ही गेट्स बेनिफिट इन द बैक पेन, नेक पेन एंड एब्डोमिनल प्रॉब्लम्स ऑल्सो. For asthma patient during the attack, nothing can be given except allopathy injection. But in yoga, chair breathing practice can be given. So all the stages of disease, varieties of practices are there. And you all know Shavasana is the best thing one can think of. Okay. So finally, I will summarize the things in less than 5 minutes. Okay. Which you can, now I can't say take home tips because now everybody is at home. So nothing is to be taken home, but you can, you know, keep in your memory box, in your brain, you know, and you can save it. Yoga therapy treats the root cause. This is the main benefit. And that's why only it takes time by, you know, and then by altering the lifestyle. If you can alter your lifestyle, that is the best therapy which no other can offer. And nowadays, even medical personalities also have started giving the title that it is lifestyle disorder. And they are also taking you to the correct lifestyle, which normally nobody follows. Because those patients think that doctor has given me prescription, goli and all injection. No, that will cure me. What is the, you know, meaning of lifestyle corrections? So they don't bother. But yoga therapies through counseling and all even can take the patients out of addictions, alcohol and smoking also, which normally doctor doesn't bother about that. And this yoga therapy is multitask to do. It works at all the levels, all the koshas, and it has got active mode. Patient has to do it himself, and he himself will get indicators. He himself will get the results, but he has to do it consistently, taking full awareness, you know, keeping full awareness on that, what he is doing. Awareness inside and awareness outside. This is what yoga has to offer. And this is the minimum definition of yoga, which is awareness. Nothing else. And that's how self-awareness will take you towards the corrections of all the symptoms. Discipline, yoga is the best discipline, and it gives you disciplined lifestyle. And of course, the main cause of diseases is speed of the life, speed of the thoughts. And yoga has to offer, minimize the speed of thoughts, speed of, you know, running your body, running your mind, everything. So relaxation is the best remedy, which is, as I told you, parasympathetic dominance is required in your life. Even, you know, corporate executives, when we teach them 12 hours, they are on computers and so much of the stress is accumulated. They also are given 1 or 2 minutes in between relaxation. How to do that? 1 or 2 minutes meditation, and they keep fit themselves. Many, many places, government organizations and private companies, we have observed, and we have got the best results out of such kind of 2 minutes remedies. आजकल खाने में 2 minutes nodule आता है, वैसे 2 minutes remedies we have to give. Though original scriptures don't describe, but then we have to find out of them only. And yoga has potential to cure all. Everything can be cured. I have met patients who were declared from Australia, Europe, and US hospital-based hospitals also. That now you have to count days only. Death is nearby. You go, take God's name, sit at home. And they have come to such ashramas in India. There are so many places. Bihar School of Yoga, S. Vyasa, Kevaliya Dham, so many ashramas. I should not take name. Rishikesh and Kerala and so many ashramas are there. Because ashramas life gives you 24/7 awareness. क्या खाना है, क्या पीना है, कैसे रहना है, किधर अवेयरनेस रखना है, एंड नो स्ट्रेस फ्रॉम आउटसाइड, नो टीवी, नो न्यूज विच गिव्स यू स्ट्रेस एवरी डे, ओके, नो पॉलिटिक्स. सो सच प्लेसेस, यू नो, दे हैव कंप्लीटली क्योर्ड, दे आर रनिंग, दे आर डूइंग मैराथन रनिंग आफ्टर 5 years. एंड देन यू नो बाय टेस्टिंग डॉक्टर्स हैव डिक्लेयर्ड देयर आर नो कैंसर सेल्स विच दे कैन डिटेक्ट. सो दीज आर द रिजल्ट. सो योगा इज क्योर फॉर एवरीथिंग, बट therapist cannot claim. The patient should try. Patients and therapists together should try. Then the results are there. And this is costless and unique therapy. Going close to the nature is remedy. And of course, each and every practice of yoga has got spiritual element. So spirituality is the final goal, and all in between, personality development, memory and concentration improvement, getting relief from the symptoms. Okay. To take your pain threshold level corrected, your pain bearing capacity can be taken up. All these are in between stations, which you will enjoy while traveling towards spirituality. And those spiritual element is there which cannot be measured, but it is most scientific. Each and every aspect has been measured. All the researchers have proved that so and so things can be completely cured with so and so yoga module. This, you go through all the research, thousands and thousands of yoga papers are there, where you can find all those non-curable diseases also are totally kept under control, and normal lifestyle the patients are living. This is the message from yoga therapy. Thank you very much.